Let us start with the 28th class of this series. Our first topic is Bacillus Calmette-Guérin vaccine. Why this vaccine is in use? This is a very old vaccine, okay? This is used for tuberculosis treatment, or you can say vaccination, the immunity development. But this is in use because some US researchers said that India has been using this BCG vaccine for tuberculosis. And only because of that, India is seeing, or in India, a few deaths are seen because of COVID-19. How they are relating is that there is a mechanism. BCG vaccine has some weakened bacteria strain that causes the tuberculosis. So how this vaccine works? Once the BCG vaccine is given in the children or maybe adult also, the immune response is provoked. That immune response is by the antibodies that attack the TB bacteria. But this BCG vaccine is very unique. This also generates the adaptive immune response and also generates your innate immune response. When the innate immune response is developed, that will mean that this BCG vaccine will help fight other diseases also. So those other diseases can include the COVID-19 also. So you understand the concept here. This is specifically for the tuberculosis. That is the adaptive immunity that is generated. But along with that, this BCG vaccine also develops the innate immunity, and that innate immunity will work towards fighting any diseases including COVID-19. This is said by the US-based researchers. So a small introduction about the BCG vaccine. This vaccine is also in your universal immunization program. You should know that. And can you comment in the comment section that what are the other vaccines given in universal immunization program of India? So in countries where either tuberculosis or leprosy is very common, one dose of BCG vaccine is recommended in healthy babies, okay, as close as to the time of birth. And when you do not have this tuberculosis problem to a large extent, only children those are having the high risk of tuberculosis, only those are immunized with the BCG vaccine. And after that, if somebody gets the tuberculosis, individual treatment, testing, is everything is done. But the study talks about India. The US researchers are saying that India is seeing less number of deaths because of COVID-19, because India has this BCG vaccine in its universal immunization program, and that is developing the innate immunity and helping people fight this COVID-19 infection. But the Indian scientists are saying, and the doctors are saying, that no, we cannot rely on this study, because see, in India, your tuberculosis vaccine or BCG vaccine has been there in policy since 1968. It is a very old vaccine, so we cannot infer that this is only working. There may be some other reasons also. Maybe Indian people might have more immunity to the infection, maybe because of that, maybe that because of environment. So many factors are there. So this study is not very well accepted in Indian scientist and doctor community. But still, why this came in April? Because at that time, your Oxford and Moderna vaccines were not in use. They were in trial stage, testing stage, and human trial stage also. But a study was not out. In that moment, scientists were looking for various other options. And in that moment, BCG was also looked upon. So that is why it was in use. That's all about BCG vaccination. Our second topic is Indian Initiative on Earth Biogenome Sequencing. In this topic, we will understand what is Earth Biogenome Sequencing in India. And also we will understand what is genome sequencing. What was the news? There is one institute. The institute is named as Jawaharlal Nehru Tropical Botanical Garden and Research Institute. And this institute has been selected to take part in Indian Initiative on Earth Biogenome Sequences. So what are the highlights of this news? See, this institute has been chosen as one of the Biological Knowledge and Resource Centers of India Initiative on Earth Biogenome Sequencing. That is the news. Only this institute is present. That is not the case. This institute will be collaborating with other premier research institutions of the same kind, and they will use very high-end technology, cutting-edge technology for genome sequencing of plants mainly. The Union Department of Biotechnology present in the Ministry of Science and Technology has allocated this much funds for this project, and they have given this fund to Jawaharlal Nehru Tropical Botanical Garden and Research Institute. Your Jawaharlal Nehru Tropical Botanical Garden and Research Institute today has 5,000 plant species in its field gene bank. See, 5,000 plant species in field gene bank and conservatories. And that is why this institute has a major role in conserving the endemic flora of the Western Ghats. The flora which are present in the Western Ghats only, the plants which are present in the Western Ghat only, and they are endemic. So we need to sequence their genome so that we can conserve them better and we can understand them better, and so that their extinction doesn't happen. दिस वॉज ऑल द न्यूज़ हाईलाइट एंड अबाउट दैट इंस्टीट्यूट. नाउ अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज जीनोम सिक्वेंसिंग. सी वन इज जीनोम. जीनोम इज द सम टोटल ऑफ ऑल जेनेटिक मटेरियल प्रेजेंट इन एन ऑर्गेनिज्म. एंड सिक्वेंसिंग वेरी सिंपल टर्म. वी ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द सिक्वेंस ऑफ द जीनोम, द DNA सिक्वेंस एंड एवरीथिंग, हाउ द DNA इज मेकिंग द जीनोम ऑफ दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म. दैट सिक्वेंसिंग इज कॉल्ड एज जीनोम सिक्वेंसिंग. सो अ जीनोम इज एन ऑर्गेनिजम्स कंप्लीट सेट ऑफ DNA. आई टोल्ड यू ऑलरेडी, कंप्लीट सेट ऑफ DNA और कंप्लीट सेट ऑफ जीन्स इज जीनोम, इंक्लूडिंग ऑल ऑफ इट्स जीन्स. इट कंटेन्स वॉट? इट कंटेन्स द इन्फॉर्मेशन नीडेड टू बिल्ड एंड मेंटेन दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म. ऑल योर प्रोटीन्स आर कोडेड बाई दिस जीनोम ओनली. All your RNA is coded by this genome only. Even the DNA replication happens by this genome only. So that is the importance of your genome, that it helps to build the whole organism and maintain that organism whole throughout the life, whether it is plant or animal or bacteria or even virus. So what happens after genome sequencing? Once you know the sequence of the genome, sequence of the gene and genetic material, researchers can know the functions of gene, okay? Which gene is functioning what? So once we know the function of the gene, suppose a malformed gene is present there or a mutated gene is present there, we can alter or we can introduce a new gene so that a new function will be introduced. Once we know the gene's role, we can do the alteration, modification, deletion and everything. And we can also identify which genes are critical for the maintenance of that organism, and that will lead to protection and conservation of that organism. So do you know where the genetic material is present in a plant? First of all, it is present in organism's chromosomal DNA in the nucleus, fine. Apart from that, in plants, genetic material or DNA is present in mitochondria also and chloroplast also. So in genome sequencing, what we will do? Only the nucleus chromosomal DNA? No. Organism's chromosomal DNA, mitochondrial DNA and chloroplastic DNA. Everything is sequenced so that we do not miss any information out of it. In fact, your mitochondrial DNA and chloroplast DNA also have some major functions. Now come to this topic, Earth Biogenome Project, what is that? First of all, understand that this is not an Indian project entirely. This project is very much international, but India is also having part over there. And in that part, this Jawaharlal Nehru Institute is participating majorly, and that is why government has given a lot of fund through its Department of Biotechnology. This Earth Biogenome Project is actually coming by an international consortium of scientists. Some scientists decided that we will try to know the genome sequence of 1000 plant and animal species, both plant and animal species, in next 5 years. Main objective is to sequence about 1000 genome of plant and animal species in the next 5 years. They will do the sequencing, catalog and characterize the genomes of all Earth's eukaryotic biodiversity over a period of 10 years, and initially 1000 plant and animal species in next 5 years. There are three main goals. First is protecting the biodiversity. Once you know the gene, genetic function, genetic code and everything, you will be able to protect the biodiversity. You will better understand the ecosystem, and finally this information can be useful for benefiting the human life. This project was officially launched in November 2018. And in that project only you have the Indian part, that is Indian Initiative on Earth Biogenome Sequencing. In India, the National Institute of Plant Genome Research, New Delhi, is the coordinating center for this nationwide project, and that involves 24 projects. Out of that, one major institute is your Jawaharlal Nehru Institute. Now you must be very curious how this project starts. So for that we will go to Wikipedia. See, this initiative was first of all inspired by Human Genome Project, okay? And initially, it emerged in 2015. There was a meeting going on between some scientists, Harris Levin, Gene E. Robinson, John Kress. All of them are associated with some U.S. institution, a Smithsonian Institute's National Museum of Natural History. They decided that we will collaborate with the world scientists and do the genome sequencing, and that is what the project we are seeing today. In 2017, they came with a 10-year project, okay? So we will see the significance of the project. This will eventually, at last, lead to the generation of genetic blueprint of all living organisms, all living forms. Blueprint is what? Just a copy of them, okay? As I told you from the Wikipedia, this digital repository of genome sequencing will help better understand your ecosystem, and it will also help in conservation of biodiversity. and you will also find new treatments for infectious and inherited disease. And maybe once we are completing the genome sequencing of other organisms, human genome project is almost already completed. So once you know everything about every genetic disease and everything about the genes of the animals and plants, maybe you can deal with the COVID-19 situation like diseases better. We can also develop new agricultural products because we are going to know the genome sequence of plants. We can develop new biomaterials and biological fuels also can be developed. And also, this project will help in curbing evil practices like biopiracy because we will check and we will test and we will know that according to the genetic material, this biopiracy is happening. And with this, you know, DNA fingerprinting and everything, that is also can be related to genome sequencing. Once India participates in this project, already participating, it will provide a boost for the field of genomics and bioinformatics within the country. India was planning to go in this bioinformatics and biotechnology boom, but the boom is still not happening. So once India participates in some international initiatives, maybe this can happen. Your bioinformatics, genetics and genomics and biotechnology can see a boom in the country, just like information technology sector. So that is some commercial value also. Our next topic is very important, and I think you should carefully listen to this, what is the case, because anybody seeing the COVID-19 patients should know about this, okay? Because this is very much in news, and also a critical case of COVID-19 cases where the people die. What happens that scientists are coming to a conclusion, they are seeing some evidence that this is a case of cytokine storm syndrome. We will understand what is that and how this is associated with COVID-19. What is cytokine storms? See, first of all, the news is that there are evidences, accumulating evidences. So that means multiple evidences. News is that a subset of patients with the severe COVID-19 is like developing the severe pneumonia, okay? So a subset of population, see COVID-19, many people are recovering very fast, okay? I know many people who have recovered in 5 or 6 days, generally. There are some patients who are not able to recover because of comorbidity, having the problem of high blood pressure or cancer, some diseases like that. And when they infected, the chances are very rare that they will be recovering very fast, and sometimes they don't even recover. But there is a subset of patients, where it is a guess that they might have already this cytokine storm syndrome, and once they are infected with COVID-19, this cytokine storm syndrome comes into action and that takes the life. So what happens? First of all, if we come to a definition of cytokine storm syndrome, definition can be an overly vigorous immune response to a triggering event, for example, viral infection. Very normally, anybody getting an infection, the body's immune response will trigger, okay? But what will happen if the response of the immune system is very high, very vigorous, okay? That leads to the damage of the body's cells and organs. If the immune response is overly, that is extraordinarily vigorous, that will lead to multiple organ failure, that will lead to liver failure, lung failure, and then the patients die. So first of all, definition of severe COVID-19 patients. The severe COVID-19 patients are those patients which show that there is respiratory failure requiring mechanical ventilation, ICU hospitalization, mechanical ventilation, otherwise they will not survive. There are shock, okay, there are organ failure, and that requires intensive care or ICU, and if not provided, that might lead to death. This is severe COVID-19 patient subset, okay? Now, what is cytokine storm syndrome? First of all, understand that this is not exactly something which comes in response of COVID-19 only. Some people have this cytokine storm syndrome, and when those people are infected, the chances are that those people will suffer from severe COVID-19 situation. First of all, understand how your body's immune response works. You know, your immune system protects you from bacteria, viruses, and other parasites by removing them from our system, or eliminating them. Immune response also kills those cells which are already infected so that the infection does not reach to other cells. All of this is your immunity, that can be acquired immunity, that can be innate immunity. How does your first time your immune system will get activated by the things that the body does not recognize as its own? Body will say that this is something coming from outside, we do not recognize these things, These things are known as antigens coming from outside. That can be bacteria, that can be fungi, that can be viruses. In response of that, your body will produce some antibodies, T killer cells and everything. But in general, we can say that your effective immune response system involves inflammation. For example, you got some injury in the knee. You will see the red and swollen area. That is your inflammation. Very normal thing. Inflammation should happen. Inflammation should happen. That is an indispensable part of the process. Only then the treatment and the healing can be done. And why that area is swollen and red? Because more blood supply goes there for the healing process. So inflammation is looking bad, but inflammation is necessary. That is your immune response. After that, immune system develops the white blood cells, and those blood cells go to the injured area, and the recovery and the repair, everything happens with the blood flow. If that doesn't happen, injury would not heal and it will lead to infection, and that can become deadly. So this is the normal immune response, no problem. And where in this immune response your cytokines fit? Cytokines are inflammatory immunological proteins, okay? Inflammatory, when this inflammation happens, in that moment cytokines are inflammatory immunological proteins that are there to fight off infections, and they also ward off the cancer cells. When these cytokines are released in the response of inflammation, cytokines are actually mediators. When the infection happens or inflammation happens, cytokines will ask the body to release or increase the blood flow in that area so that the WBCs can go there and have some action, and the recovery and repair process can be aided. But suppose this inflammation response is not regulated and there is a storm of cytokines. So much of blood cells will go there, so much of WBC will go there. This process can be very dangerous. This is what is known as cytokine storm syndrome, okay? Here happens the overproduction of immune cells and cytokines themselves because of a dysregulation in the process. You understood what? Infection happened, inflammation happened. Cytokine was to act as a mediator so that the WBC and everything will go there and the recovery will be done, repair will be done. But now a storm of cytokines come. First of all, this dysregulation happens at this step. The cytokines are not limited, they are coming in unlimited amount. And then in response of unlimited amount of cytokines, a lot of blood cells, overproduction of immune cells will happen. Obviously, anything overly produced can be a damage to the body. This dysregulation or overproduction of cytokine or cytokine storm can occur due to an infection, and also there the person can be having an autoimmune condition where the body's immune system attacks the own body's healthy cells. In case of celiac disease, an immune disorder that primarily affects the small intestine. There are other examples also. Some body cells will start attacking the brain cells only. Symptoms will be high fever, inflammation, redness and swelling, severe fatigue and nausea. In the case of any flu infection, a cytokine storm is associated with. If there is one flu infection, in that disease, if cytokine storm happens, if this failure happens, overproduction happens, that will be associated with a surge of activated immune cells. And where? Because it is a flu infection, the activated immune cells will go to repair the lungs, okay? Which instead of fighting off the antigen leads to lung inflammation and fluid buildup, because WBC is coming, blood is coming, so fluid buildup will happen, and the respiratory distress and artificial oxygen supply will be needed. If that is not taken care in limited time, as soon as possible, that can lead to death. So once the high production of cytokines happens, the immune system will start attacking your healthy cells also. So healthy tissues of the lungs will be affected and the pneumonia will get severe. Sepsis can happen. Sepsis is the infection of the blood, and potentially death can also happen. Multiple organ failure can happen, and any time your body's multiple organ failure, that means kidney is also affected, liver is also affected, lung is also affected, in that situation it is very hard to recover for the patient. That's all about cytokine storm. Now come to the next storm. The next news is integrated government online training. Government online training, GOT, don't consider it trading, okay? This is integrated government online training portal. What is that? This is, as the name says, this is an online training platform I got in the fight against COVID-19. This was created to fight off COVID-19, and that provides training. I will tell you who is provided training in this portal. बट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल नो दैट दिस इज लॉन्च बाय डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पर्सनल एंड ट्रेनिंग, ओके, नॉट बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर. दिस इज लॉन्च बाय डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पर्सनल एंड ट्रेनिंग. कैन यू टेल मी इन विच मिनिस्ट्री, और इज इट डायरेक्टली अंडर द प्राइम मिनिस्टर? कैन यू टेल मी इन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन विच मिनिस्ट्री इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल और विच मिनिस्ट्री इज हैविंग द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पर्सनल एंड ट्रेनिंग एंड हु इज द हेड ऑफ दिस मिनिस्ट्री? दिस इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट यू शुड नो. दिस प्लेटफॉर्म इज कॉल्ड आई गॉट इंटीग्रेटेड गवर्नमेंट ऑनलाइन ट्रेनिंग. सो हु इज इट फॉर और वॉट इज इट फॉर? इट ऑफर्स ऑनलाइन ट्रेनिंग फॉर डॉक्टर्स, नर्सेज, पैरामेडिक्स, हाइजीन वर्कर्स, टेक्नीशियंस, ऑक्जिलरी नर्सिंग मिडवाइफ्स ऑल्सो, सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसर्स ऑल्सो, सिविल डिफेंस ऑफिसर. दैट इज बाय द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पर्सनल एंड ट्रेनिंग. ओके, दिस इज नॉट अबाउट द मेडिकल पर्सन. सी, सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसर्स ऑल्सो, सो IAS विल ऑल्सो गेट द ट्रेनिंग. सिविल डिफेंस ऑफिसर्स, वेरियस पुलिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, NCC, NYKS, NSS, इंडियन रेड क्रॉस सोसाइटी ऑल्सो, भारत स्काउट एंड गाइड ऑल्सो, एंड ऑल अदर वॉलंटियर्स हु आर हेल्पिंग द नेशन फाइट द COVID-19 पैंडेमिक. वेरियस काइंड ऑफ ट्रेनिंग विल बी गिवन थ्रू दिस ऑनलाइन ट्रेनिंग प्लेटफॉर्म आई गॉट बाय द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पर्सनल एंड ट्रेनिंग. सो वॉट आर द की फीचर्स ऑफ दिस प्लेटफॉर्म? सी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पर्सनल एंड ट्रेनिंग इज लाइक द क्रिएटर ऑफ दिस प्लेटफॉर्म, बट इट इज होस्टेड ऑन द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट मिनिस्ट्री दीक्षा प्लेटफॉर्म. ओके, hosted on Diksha platform of the Ministry of Human Resources Development, now what? Now Education Ministry, okay? But created by Department of Personnel and Training, because the training is being provided to the personnel. It delivers, as expected, curated, that means filtered, selected, role-specific content, so that the nurses should do that, midwives should do that, IAS should do that, to each learner at their place of work or home, because some people are having the home confinement right now, so the home training will also be given online and to any device of their choice. They can choose, they want to learn at office or they want to learn at home, but this is available online, so not a problem. Why there was a need? Just for training your COVID-19 warriors of the country. India's first line of workers are already engaged in COVID-19 relief, but a large force will be needed, the large number of volunteers. That is why the names are coming like Bharat Scout and Guide, NSS and everything, because large workforce will be needed to replace the first line and to deal with the exponential or geometric increase in COVID-19. If that happens, we need more people, we need more trained people. Not only the regular workers can deal with this situation if there is a blast of cases in COVID-19 positive cases in subsequent stages of the pandemic. Hence, the platform can be useful to combat. This is like preparing for the disaster already that might happen. Hence, the platform can be useful to combat COVID-19 for all frontline workers and equip them with the training and updates in coping with the pandemic. This is a place where you will find the one-stop source to learn about critical areas and update knowledge and capacity, and everything general training is given, role-specific training is given. Next thing we need to know is integrated geospatial platform and also Sahyog app. What are these? These are two sides of the same coin. The online platform is integrated geospatial platform and the app is Sahyog app. Who made this? Department of Science and Technology under the Ministry of Science and Technology, Government of India, has created this integrated geospatial. That means it will be using the satellite data and everything. Integrated geospatial platform out of available geospatial data sets, whatever ISRO has given or US GPS has given, using that data, geospatial data sets, standard bit services will be provided, analytical tools will be provided to the decision makers of the governance so that they can better deal with this COVID-19 outbreak in an area, and so that the management and everything can be done geospatially. Okay, for that the Department of Science and Technology has come with integrated geospatial platform. What does that mean? That means area specific strategies so that we can handle the socio-economic impact in the recovery phase of COVID-19. This is the web portal. The mobile application is Sahyog app. Very easy. Because there is survey involved, there is area involved, geospatial data involved. So mobile as well as your Sahyog app, both are prepared and managed by the Survey of India. Okay, one correction. This is by your Department of Science and Technology, Integrated Geospatial Platform. This Sahyog app is developed by Survey of India. Sahyog app and Sahyog app's only web portal. Here we are talking about Sahyog app and its web portal. Both are developed and managed by the Survey of India. This is different from Department of Science Technologies Integrated Geospatial Platform. Correct that, okay? Sorry. This has been customized to collect COVID-19 specific geospatial data sets through community engagement to augment the response activities by the Government of India to the pandemic, and it will complement your Arogya Setu app. So this is also about geospatial data, and this one was also about the geospatial data. The difference is that integrated geospatial platform is coming by Department of Science and Technology, and your Sahyog app and its web portal is coming by Sahyog app and web portal is coming by your Survey of India. This will also collect COVID-19 specific geospatial data sets, and those data sets will be integrated with Arogya Setu app. That is why you can know na, under 500 meters how many people are infected, under 2000 kilometers how many people are infected and everything. That's all for today. See you in the next lecture. And in the next lecture also we will be doing some science and technology topics only. And most of the science and technology topics these days are associated with COVID-19. So sometimes they become boring also, sometimes they become interesting also. But anybody preparing for civil services this year or the next year has to know everything about, whether it's science and technology or environment or economy of COVID-19 pandemic, we should know. So that's all for today. Take care. Bye-bye.